Hi, good morning, everybody. Hey, I have wonderful to start off our webinar, and it was so good to have people from United States, Canada, Philippines, and Singapore, New Zealand. Wow, quite a few different places, actually. It was kind of unique. Anyway, today, the reason why I think that this is going to be a continuous webinar from our previous discussion, why sleeping is so important. One of the reasons is because I found that many people kind of ignore about sleeping for diabetes. And as you know, if you are diabetic, you can also can potentially, if you don't sleep well, erase your blood sugar. Well, I'm going to welcome some of my friends here, like Eugene. Eugene, can you see your Facebook also? Give me a two if you can see Facebook, if you can. That would be wonderful. And, oh, wonderful. Great. Thank you. But anyway, a lot of people start coming to me and start getting, asking more information. So there, that result, I realized a lot of people just don't remember, to actually focus in sleeping is actually important, task for diabetes patients. So I thought that it would be really good to, have this webinar to create it. And so we make this webinar a lot more detailed and hope that with that, you will get some lot more information, how to do better sleep. And with that, you can actually lower your blood sugar. And that's the whole purpose of this continued discussion. And then also in March 26, we're going to have a really good discussion about kidney disease for diabetic kidney disease. The reason is, about 30% of a typical diabetic patient might end up with diabetic kidney disease. So that is actually can be a serious issue, because if you don't take care of kidney, at the end of the day, if it doesn't work, you know what? You're going to end up with dialysis. And I used to work for Baxter International, and I brought CAPD, a very good form of dialysis, into Asia Pacific. And I see, at that time, 50% of my patients have diabetes, now 75%. I saw people are tremendously suffering from the kidney issues. So you guys need to spend some time, listen to about 1 hour, and then with Professor Larry Chan, who is a guru in diabetes, dialysis. And so it will be really nice to have him to work with us and give us that lectures. So do mark down on your calendar. It's going to be at... for Hong Kong, will be 11 a.m. on March 26. For people from Hawaii, USA, will be on the 25th at 5 p.m. just like right now, and California time will be 7 p.m. So just make sure you write it down on your calendar. I think it will be really a wonderful thing that you don't want to miss. Okay. Hi, 各位朋友, I'm Angela Lu, Shudi President. Hey, 首先多謝各位朋友啊, 在不同的地方有 Singapore, 馬來西亞, 這個, Canada, Canada, 和, California, 很多人在這裡一起聽今天講書, 其實為什麼會講多一堂書, 關於睡覺呢, 問題就很多時候呢, 原來很多, 糖尿病者就忘記了睡覺原來很重要的東西來的, 咁原來呢瞓覺瞓得唔好呢真係會 increase the blood sugar。 咁我呢個呢係上一次講得好清楚。咁上一堂呢講就點解你會有啲咁嘅情況發生呢。咁呢個其實呢就因為係好多譬如好似我個頸已經好大個啊，咁好多時呢就snoring 好大啊，即係鼻鼾好高啊，咁亦都阻塞咗嗰啲睡眠窒息症嘅影響呢，令到係會 唞唔到氣啊，咁其實講咗呢啲係摸我哋嘅身體上嘅難題，咁今次咧係俾多啲機會咧，你了解點能夠用咩方法咁樣瞓覺更好咧，今日呢個堂咧係講呢樣嘢，所以係十分十分好嘅，咁幫助你能夠更加多了解，OK？ So, thank you for all joining us, coming in now. We have so many different people from all over the world. But today, why I want to continue this webinar is because a lot of people just kind of forgot why it's so important to, have good sleep. And that's why, and why good sleep will actually affect your blood sugar going up. So I really want to make sure that you guys have a clear understanding. So don't ignore sleep, basically, okay? And last week we talked about more on the body issues, like for example, why when you have breathing difficulty because you snore and you affect your breathing, and then the net result, it will make you sleep very difficult. So a lot of more on a body physical issue, but this time we're going to teach you more about ways and tips, how you ways to get you better sleep and really get a good sleep and decrease blood sugars, okay? So I'm going to start my seminar now, and then I will share my screen. So we'll go from there. Let me see right here. Good. And hopefully everybody can see that. Eugene, can you see that you guys can able to see the screen? Give me a one if you can. That would be great. I think you can, basically. Okay, good. So today we'll talk about the 20 ways to sleep better when you're pre-diabetic, diabetic. Now, so important. A lot of people don't realize, hey, you're pre-diabetic. It's the same thing. Absolutely, it's the same thing. Because if you are pre-diabetic, you don't sleep well, you also will potentially get really, your blood sugar also go up. So I'm going to stand at least 5 minutes just to catch up with the people, because a lot of new people come in. And so I want to make sure that they also know what is diabetes. And so they're all from everybody have the same level of platform. So they will sort of go together. And so this 5 minutes just to catch up. Okay. So keep in mind, diabetes is a chronic disease. You don't get well. All you got to do is you got to control your blood sugar. The worst thing is because diabetes affects your entire body, all the vessels. And later on, I would show you why it's so important, because all the plaques are formed everywhere, and that will affect your entire body. That's really sad. And that's why it's so important. And you got to control your blood sugar to prevent that. And so you don't get to complication. And pre-diabetic is the same thing. So how do you control blood sugar? Very simple. Basically, you have the proper dieting, exercise, weight management, and then you have to measure blood sugar by poking a finger. And then you got to eliminate all the white food, meaning the rice or limit a little, or your juice, a sugary drink, bread, all those things has to be, really substantially decreased. And certainly we have low sugar tea, which is a product really can help you to lower your blood sugar and continue drinking that. So anyway, this is where we start off. And everybody have really, if you have diabetes, only thing you can control. And you need to bring your A1C down to below 6.4. And if you're over 6.4, you still can bring it down. And up to you can able to control your diet, blood sugar, diet, exercise, and weight. And I assure you, I tell you, weight is so important. And I'll show you a little while why this is so important too. Okay, now this is a very important slide. Because I think all the people who join in, like Judith, thank you very much, Judith Clark. I appreciate you actually joining us today. Reason is this is really show you how diabetes all started off, okay? Now, first thing usually is your cholesterol, which is the LDL cholesterol, start going up. And it will damage what? Your B cell come from your pancreas. And if the B cell pancreas are damaged, from the pancreas, they don't carry the sugar into this to the cells. So net result, more and more blood sugar going up. Now, when you have that happen, the sugar and cholesterol will make the blood become very thickened and start forming plaques everywhere. From your brain, your everywhere, the entire body. Okay, so that is why when long term complication, that's where you come. When you have a lot of plaque going up everywhere in the body, you know what? All these plaque will eliminate space, so your blood pressure second stage should go up. And when that happens, your blood sugar continue to go up. And then if you don't do anything, lifestyle is the same. You know what? The third stage is you become a pre-diabetic, which is mean your A1C will start from 5.7. A1C is the hemoglobin cells, all the sugar attached to the percent of sugar is 5.7 is the normal. But if you go, if sugar going up, it will become 5.7 all the way to 6.4. With this, you are a pre-diabetic. And once you're over 6.4, you're 6.5, you are diabetes. And the stage four, yes, you have diabetes. And once you got confirmed as diabetes, after a year, two-time test, then you are not going to go back. They will still call you a diabetes. Okay, so keep that in mind. And really don't want to go into this stage. And that's why we try to do a lot of education, hopefully that will get everybody not to go into diabetes if they're pre-diabetic. 各位同學，我係Andrew啦，咁講過啦，咁其實好重要咧，就我哋講翻咧，就係第一，我哋其實咧，如果糖尿病者係唔會好嘅，只係控制嘅啫。咩叫控制咧？就糖尿同埋前期嘅慢病都要控制，係將佢個A1C跌到係6.4以下。咁其實咧，點解呢個糖尿病咁重要咧？呢個好重要就係呢一度呢張slice啊，呢張slice係講及咧，第一你嘅。 膽固醇會上去啦，咁膽固醇就損壞咗你嘅 B cells 啦。當你損壞咗 B cell 之後咧，咁你嘅B cell 就唔會帶啲糖入去個細胞裏邊咯。咁如果唔帶啲糖入細胞裏邊咧，弊家伙啦。咁嗰啲糖同埋個 cholesterol LDL 咧就會一路係咁上去。咁你咧個血咧就變咁好結啦，好結咧就 form 咗啲咁嘅 plaque 咧 everywhere 成身都係啊。 咁最後咧，咁你就一個第二個 stage 出嚟嘅血啊，就會開始慢慢上嚟噶啦。咁如果你繼續都係一樣嘅生活啦，冇轉到咧，咁弊啦。咁之後咧，你個 A1C 咧就由5.7，A1C 就紅血球個細胞叫啊 hemoglobin， 紅血球咧就會嗰啲糖 attach 佢有 percent 嘅 attach 嘅。咁如果你繼續係咁上去嘅時候咧，就你個糖咧就會繼續上去由5.7 percent 至到係6.4。 過咗咁上咧，第四個 stage 你就已經糖尿病患者啦。嗱，多數喺全世界都咁度呢個 A1C 噶，所以如果你想知道你係咩情況，你一定問醫生我 A1C 係幾多咧？咁其實 ，so actually why we ask people to drink low sugar tea and why it works is because low sugar tea has two products in there. It's called guava leaves, which block the sugar into the vessels, and then the bitter melon. Will take they increase the sensitivity of the insulin and take sugar in the cells. But that's one more thing that's so important. Bitter melon will work is they also take the excess sugar out from from the urine, and dump that off, and also cholesterol also dumped off, plus the salt come off. So at the end of the day, your three things will come off. One, your sugar comes up, your cholesterol comes up, and last but not least, because the salt comes up, your blood sugar will, pressure will also come down. So that's why drinking low sugar tea works, and that's why it's so important. 各位糖友，其实点解饮去糖茶咁重要咧？因为佢去糖茶咧系有两个 ingredient 喺入边嘅，第一个就系呢个番石榴叶啦，番石榴就 block 咗糖，唔俾佢入去个血管里边。咁第二样嘢咧就嗰个苦瓜。 苦瓜咧，其實咧就好特別嘅，佢咧就係好似胰島素咁，但係佢就將嗰啲胰島素咧increase 咗佢個敏感度，increase 個 sensitivity 敏感度，咁佢就帶翻啲糖入去細胞裏邊。咁仲有咧，如果你有啲 excess 嘅糖，多咗糖出嚟咧，佢就喺尿嗰度掉啲糖出嚟，佢掉埋 cholesterol 出嚟，仲有掉埋個鹽出嚟。當你做呢啲咧，佢就第一降低咗你個。 糖啦，第二降咧膽固醇咧，第三有一個好重要咧，就降低你血壓，因為減咗鹽之後咧，你血壓就會降低噶。So if you do not do anything, continue my lifestyle, the risk is that is really sad because the risk is going to have you, one, you have potential with stroke, you're going to have cataract issue, you have pancreas malfunction doesn't work. More important, 40-60% with heart disease because all the plaques start blocking all the vessels. So you might end up with heart disease. And then the worst that you've got nerve damage because, you know, plugging all the sugars all over the head and so forth, you can't get the feel. When you have nerve damage, it will not get your nerve to feel your pain and so forth. And that is actually very dangerous at the end of the day. Because when you have injury, you don't feel it, and you get infected, you end up a foot might be cut off. And then you also, because the blood with all the plaques everywhere, so your blood pressure goes up, blood vessels will be damaged. And then we will talk about in 26, March 26 is how do you get diabetic nephropathy? In other words, your kidney will totally damage because can't filter it anymore. So how that works? So Professor Larry Chen will talk about that. And really sad, 30% of diabetic patients have no sex life because they can't feel, because of the nerve damage. So really at the end of the day, you have all kind of problems. Plus if you're pregnant, you have a potential also with gestation diabetic, eventually change your diabetes. So diabetic is a lifelong disease. Matter of fact, my professor friend was telling me, you think COVID is bad? This is worse because this affects your whole life. Okay, so be that really serious to it. Okay, 各位朋友，如果你咩唔做咧，好大問題咧，就係end up你就會有中風嘅問題啦，有眼青光眼啦，睇唔到嘢盲啦，你個胰臟開始壞啦，咁出唔到胰島素啦，仲有心臟病啦，40%至60%病人咧係有心臟病啊，仲有神經系統損壞啦，如果神經系統損壞咧，好大問題，你感覺唔到咧，咁你樣嘢落去嘅時候咧，你就一個好大好大嘅問題。 醒傷咗，你又唔知道啦，咁喺度發炎啦，腳都係割埋啦，咁你血管亦都開始全部硬化，好多 plaque 啊，咁啊 damage 使血管啦，血壓高啦，咁仲有咧腎啊整壞咗佢咧，佢洗腎啦，30%嘅糖尿病病人係冇性功能，因為冇感覺啊，咁如果 pregnancy 咧，亦都係一個問題嘅，因為如果佢有 gestation diabetic 咧，咁亦都會令到佢第時咧將來真係變大，所以糖尿病咧唔係好似即係咁簡單。 系即系一两年嘅病，系一世嘅病，所以你一定要用好多功夫咧，继续努力去将你个病咧系能够令到佢咧系可以能够痊愈。哇！呢个系好大好大嘅 benefit 嚟噶。如果你做到之后，咁你就唔会有好多后患症，因为现在嚟讲咧，当你有糖尿病嘅时候咧，就胃冇乜嘢啦。依家，但系5至10年后咧，你就好大问题出现噶，好多问题出现嘅。So our company is very unique. We have basically, also besides just asking, you know, people to drink low sugar tea, but we felt that was so important that a lot of people don't understand diabetes. So I personally, because I'm an ICU nurse, I have spent 40 years in healthcare. So I thought that it would be nice if I could able to help lots of people understand what's diabetes. And I work with dialysis for over, you know, so many years with Baxter International, seeing all these diabetic patients. So I felt that I have the capability, I have the skill set to share all these diabetic management with everybody. So net result, you will, all the people who listen to our lecture have benefit how to manage diabetes so they can be all healthy. And if I can able to help people to delay their diabetic conversion for 10, 15, 20 years, and then if the diabetes, they have about, you know, 10, 20 years, they don't get complication, hey, I think I did my job. So that is really my objective. And so we thought that with the FIVE program will help many of the pre-diabetic, diabetic patients can able to lower the blood sugar, lower the cholesterol, lower the blood pressure, the three higher lower, and they can be healthy. Wow, I think I did my job. So we have FIVE program. First program is diet. We will show you how to do all the dieting, how to lower the blood sugar, cholesterol, and so forth. And we have all kinds of lectures. We have hundreds of lectures, actually. And we'll show you how to exercise. Exercise is very simple. We just walk 10,000 steps, 150 minutes per week. It's very simple. And even with light exercise, with a barbell, those are all very simple. You can do it at home, anywhere, actually. And you got to have weight control. The BMI got to be over 23. Now, I can tell you, really, at the end of the day, if you can lower 10% of weight, your A1C will drop 1%. And it is actually is mine, okay? I can tell you my weight was 220 pounds, 2.5 years ago. And I dropped it down to 195 pounds. My A1C dropped 1%. You know what? I was almost to be diabetic because I was 6.9 A1C. Now my A1C is 6 because of just dropping weight plus certain I'm dieting and so forth. Now I'm still trying to work on my weight. So my weight now went down to 190. Imagine that. And my blood sugar are so nice now. So really at the end of the day, if you can able to drop your weight down, your blood sugar definitely improve. Plus you drinking low sugar tea, exercising. Wow, all that will come together. And you will be so much healthier. I felt so much lighter. My knee don't get pain. Wow, that is so good. And so with all that, we also have Dr. Webinar to help you out, and also blood tracking technique to help you track. So you will continue to learn how to better maintain your health. And that's why this is what we're trying to do. 各位朋友, 可能你就說我都沒什麼，我什麼這麼認真呢？其實不是，為什麼我做這麼多東西去講書啊，因為我已經做了40年healthcare了，我是ICU nurse，還有我也在東南亞introduce CAPD的腹膜透析，整個東南亞我introduce，我覺得我有這樣的knowledge，有這樣的責任，希望令到更加多人了解 什麼糖尿病，他不會受苦，也不會死神，或者任何更加嚴重的病。如果我做這件事，I think I did my job, okay? 所以我是特別做這件事，有五個program, 第一個program就是diet,你要吃東西怎麼吃，怎麼降低carbs, 我有很多這program,8個lecture那麼多的, 也有很多講書啊，講些東西。 第二個exercise, 運動是很簡單的,我們不是說要你很多很難的運動, 行。 咁簡單，行1萬步或者150分鐘一個禮拜裏面，咁你其實已經降低到你嘅磅數噶啦。第三，你係要控制你嘅磅，其實控制磅係好重要嘅。當你控制10%嘅磅減咗咧，你個 A1C 係 improve 咗幾多啊？你個 A1C improve 咗係1%，即係如果你係7嘅話，你係變咗6。其實我哋 exactly 一樣嘅，我嘅就6.9嘅，兩年前我都係。 減低咗10% 嘅磅數，225磅減90啦，唔係一二百啊，sorry，咁我嘅 A1C 已經去到係6.1咁上下啦，咁現在咧我係去190啦，咁我啲血糖係更加好，哇，真係開心到窒，所以其實咧減磅係 definitely 幫到你嘅，咁當然 diet 要點去減磅啊 ，diet 啊，同埋行啊，依啲係全部係做到係。 繼續幫助你做到一樣嘢啦，所以呢啲係 all included 嘅。OK，so today we're going to talk about 20 ways to sleep better. How do you get better sleep for pre-diabetic patient? Now this is so important because you know why? Our problem is if you don't have good quality sleep, you might close your eye, but you're not really sleeping. That is not going to help your blood sugar. This is true for all diabetic or pre-diabetic patients. It's the same thing. Unfortunately, 30% of diabetic patients, they have some form of sleep disorder, you know, and this is very much in all studies. And on top of that, majority of diabetic patients or pre-diabetic patients, they all focus on diet, 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 but they forgot one more thing. It's not only diet. Yes, you can also do some exercise, but prioritize sleeping is also so important. If you don't prioritize sleeping, you are missing one significant steps, okay? So really at the end of the day, pre-diabetic patient, you really need to have plenty good high quality sleep and you have to rest your sleep to actually let your body to regenerate so your blood sugar will definitely be good. So today we will talk about the 20 steps to get you better sleep and also tell you why this is so important to you. So we're gonna give a better conclusion and really ask you to really start practicing. Now, as I mentioned, 30% of the diabetic patient, they have some form of disorder. And that's why sleeping is so important because you don't get good sleep. You know one thing? Your blood sugar will go up. When you poor sleep, that's one important thing is your insulin is going to have high resistance. When you don't sleep well, insulin high resistance, your result, your high blood sugar will go up. Your blood sugar will go up. And the reason because you don't sleep well, your cortisol also increase, meaning you're ready to fight. So your insulin is going to have high resistance and you are not going to have, you know, bring down blood sugar, actually give you more sugar in your bloodstream because they thought that you're ready to fight, okay? And studies show that in for diabetic and pre-diabetic patient is the most important. You have at least 7 hours sleep. If you're less than 5 hours sleep, you are going to have really weird blood sugar issue. If you sleep too much, the study show 5 to 8 hours, you're over 8 hours sleep. Also, A1C didn't do well. So 7 hours sleep is really the sweet spot of sleeping somehow, okay? And this is all by study show that, wow, okay, this is so important. So everybody that's trying to get 7 hours sleep is 7 hours sleep, not 5 hours sleep, not 10 hours sleep, 9 hours sleep, is 7 hours sleep, okay? Now, the sad part is when you have not enough sleep, you know what's gonna happen is you're gonna start eating more and your blood sugar goes up. The reason why is when you have not enough sleep, the hormone called leptin, which is really, leptin is a hormone that is get you down your appetite. You know where you get more leptin, your appetite is go down, so you don't want to eat. But you don't have enough sleep. There's another hormone called ghrelin, which is increase your hunger. So you are always looking for, you know, food to eat. So when you have not enough sleep, your ghrelin hormone will go up. And then your leptin hormone will go down. So net result, you feel hungry, I want to go sleep, I want to eat, I want to do more eating, and then not that net result, you go not eating, really not healthy food. Majority of people, when they get hungry to eat, they eat all kinds of stuff like cookies, candy, whatever they come in line, they will go for it. So net result, you know, your blood sugar goes up because you eat more, and then you will start gaining weight, and plus it screw up your entire blood sugar management program, okay? Now, also, when your blood sugar goes up, your kidney will say, hey man, your blood sugar is going up. You're gonna start able to dump off your sugar out of urine because that's the kidney is supposed to do. So you're gonna go to urinate at nighttime a lot more. You're gonna go shishi a lot more. So every night you wake up, I'm gonna make all kind of urination. So your blood sugar goes up, it's gonna affect the sleep because you're gonna urinate a lot more. Now, one more thing. If your blood sugar too low also will affect your sleep. Remember when you are blood sugar low, what that means low is mean your blood sugar becomes 70 milligram per deal or 3.9 millimole per liter. So when you get restless, sleep. Remember, you know my blood sugar? You know what you do? You feel jittering, and then you're going to end up the same thing. You got restless, you have nightmare, you got sweat. So you really don't get enough sleep because you are having all kind of this issue. So that will definitely affect your sleep. And then if you have, if you are unfortunately diabetic, actually is you are three times more to able potentially to be depressed because, you know, of diabetes. A typical study, three times more diabetic patients are depressed. When you're depressed, you know what can happen? You have insomnia. You know where, you know, you don't feel like you keep thinking about all the good stuff, all the bad stuff actually, usually, and then you affect the sleep. So insomnia, another thing too, is also create depression. So really, sleep, it become very important. So remember, it's not just, you know, wow, I don't sleep well, so what? But it affect your blood sugars tremendously. 各位同學,為什麼睡覺這麼重要呢?主要糖尿病病者,don't forget, 第一,在很多study裡面,看到原來 30%的糖尿病病者呢, 都有一些這樣的睡覺的問題出現的。 咁其實呢,如果你係瞓得唔好,咁你個胰島素抗拒呢就升高嘅。咁一升高點解會升高?因為瞓得唔好,有stress啦,咁我個胰島素呢就係hormone出嚟,就cortisol,hormone,準備打仗,準備血,咪要血糖嘅症狀上高囉。咁所以有insulin resistance係高嘅,okay?咁第二樣嘢,瞓覺嘅時間只能夠最好就瞓7個鐘頭,即係for diabetes係瞓7個鐘頭啊。 唔係瞓5個鐘頭,唔係瞓10個鐘頭,瞓得多有唔好嘅A1C睇到出嚟呢,如果你瞓5個或者10個或者8個呢,佢A1C高up嘅,所以其實個最好嘅瞓覺嘅 amount 時間係7個鐘頭。如果你唔夠瞓嘅時候呢,你身體就會好緊張啦,好多 stress 啦,咁你又 end up 有樣嘢可以食嘢啦。點解呢?有兩個hormone,一個 leptin hormone就應該俾你冇胃口嘅。 有個 gremlin hormone 係應該俾你 increase 你嘅肚餓嘅。當你一唔夠瞓嘅時候呢,你個問題呢,就個 gremlin hormone 呢就會上升,咁即係話你希望會食多啲嘢啦,嗰個 leptin hormone 呢就降低,咁就變咗你唔會 唔會冇胃口啦。咁你食食好咧，就增加你血糖上去啦，增加你嘅卡路里啦，咁你有肥胖啦。咁仲有咧就係、是，如果你食得好多嘢嘅時候咧，你血糖高嘅時候咧，你個腎咧就開始掉嗰啲血糖出去，喺個尿嗰度出嚟。咁你成晚咧就去屙尿，唔使瞓覺，咁啊解瞓唔到好啦。咁仲有咧，如果你好得意咧，如果你血糖低咧，都會有同樣問題喎。譬如你係我係三點九嘅變咗，咁你記唔記得近時咧？當你係血糖低嘅時候，你有咩感受啊？你會手震啦，瞓得唔即係個成身都唔舒服啦。咁其實咧，瞓覺一樣嘅，你會開始發噩夢啦，又好即係成身唔得閒啦，會飆冷汗啦，依全部發，咁你咪瞓唔到覺啦。咁其實咧，仲有一樣嘢咧，當你係瞓唔到覺嘅時候咧，亦都會有機會令到你係會有depression 啊。咁點解咧？因為咧，當你有憂鬱症嘅時候咧，就係好多時候你成日諗住壞嘢啊，諗曬咁變咗嚟講，你就開始哇死啦，係咪人生咁慘㗎？咁呢啲咁嘅嘢咧，全部令到你瞓唔到覺，亦都瞓唔到，你開始有 depression。30%嘅糖尿病患者有。是多過普通人有 depression 的原因就是有這樣的情況，所以變成睡覺是十分重要。 So we have explained so important to sleep, and you really try hard to help yourself to make sure you can sleep. That's why I want to do this webinar with 20 ways to help you to be better sleep. So how do you get better sleep? Very simple. First of all, you have turned off all cell phone, electronic,Because what happened is all the TV, all the cell phone has this thing called blue light. That will hurt you from, you know, when the blue light turn on, it actually affect your sleep, affect your brain actually. So turn off all that. A lot of people forgot, even the digital clock also do the same thing. So they don't really cover the digital clock. So this blue light have also come up with, you know, this electronic,signal can affect your brainwave and also affect your body. So turn off all the electronic. The worst thing you do is continue watch TV until you fall asleep in the middle of the night. You know, affect you, cannot sleep. That is not a good habit. So turn off everything before you go to sleep. 嗱，各位同友，其實咧個藍燈咧，你要知道咧，所有電視啊、電話都有個藍燈嘅。其實咧，佢就係會影響睡眠嘅。咁其實咧，應該咧瞓覺之前就 shut up 咗佢 ，turn it off， 即係熄咗佢。如果唔係咧，就會成日咧瞓覺影響你瞓覺。咁其實有一個好重要咧，係你個鬧鐘啊，好多時都唔記得鬧鐘，原來係會影響咗嗰個燈嘅嚇。OK， so also a lot of people actually take 20-minute nap， but it's very important to take the nap in the early in the afternoon， not in the late afternoon like 4 or 5 o'clock because we sleep too much， then you're not gonna sleep at night。But sleeping is very good, you know. Actually, when 20-minute nap, like after lunch, you know, like take 20-minute nap, that will really refresh you. Or even take a short walk, it will be also very good. Or drink a glass of warm or cold ousu tea can be help you also. So not only nap, but also help you give you a little bit sort of change environment, and that actually relax you. Drink a little ousu tea can also help you relax. So take that.Really a way to sort of get you out of the routine and able to relax you a little bit. So either nap, walk, or drink a glass of hot or cold ousu tea can help you to become more relaxed and regenerate yourself. 各位朋友，仲有咧，其实仲有一个好重要咧，就系、是、或者你系行20分行一个好短啊，10-20分钟出去吃晏晝開行一行啊，或者瞓20分鐘啊，吃晏晝覺瞓2分鐘啊，瞌瞌眼啊，咁呢個係十分好嘅生活習慣嚟嘅。其實喺大陸咧，好多人都瞓晏覺嘅，哇，真係 work 喎，真係對身體係十分好喎。所以如果你係可以瞓到20分鐘更加好啦。如果唔係咧，行多一個10-20分鐘嘅行亦都好啦。或者飲一啲去糖茶啊，凍熱都得嘅，係飲啊，咁你就可能嘅轉換環境咧，俾一個好好嘅俾你康復一個好或者你工作上嘅東西啊，俾你能夠 relax 啊，係對十分好嘅。嗱， a lot of people forgot one thing is, wow, you know, the alarm clock actually has light come on. The worst that if you have an alarm clock that has a second go tick, tick, tick. I don't know if you ever have that problem. I have an alarm clock, one of the alarm clock that I had that tick, tick, tick. And the whole night bothers me because it keep tick, tick, tick. And I said, I can't sleep because I keep hearing at nighttime hearing this alarm clock go tick, tick, tick. So I took it, I put Barry in the bed, underneath the bed and blur and draw, and I don't hear anymore, then I could sleep. So important. If you have an alarm clock that has emitted light or it go tick, 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 so make sure that take it away. Don't keep it in there because you don't know which night will affect your sleep. So make sure that you cover that and make sure that doesn't bother you. Okay. 好啦，唔記得咗，原來喺個鬧鐘咧，有時啲鬧鐘嗰啲秒針一滴滴滴滴嗰啲啊，咁就嗰啲可能咧個聲亦都係啊幫你啊。如果有光亦都幫你啊。如果你唔記得一樣嘢，真係俾佢擺落去一個櫃桶底啊，或者 邊度啊 cover 咗佢咧，咁最多人到咧，依個唔會影響你瞓覺。其實近時咧，我有個鬧鐘真係咁嘅，哇，影響我瞓覺唔正仔。所以依個咧係要記下，係咪可能夠做呢樣嘢？Also, I found that a lot of people have back pain and back problem, and actually it would be very good to put a pillow between your two legs, and then you lie on the side, on the right hand side. That can be very, very helpful. Because it also relaxes you a low back pain and also decrease stress on your back when you have something between your two legs and help you have something that give you a little bit comfort. I guess when you're young, you remember you have to hold on some pillow or something. That is a similar function, but that will be really help. Put the pillow between your leg and that's it can be give you some comfort. And I know a lot of older folks would do that in the hospital also. That's also very helpful. Okay. 各位朋友，其實好重要咧，就擺一個枕頭喺兩隻腳之中間，咁令到你咧係覺得哇係好舒服喎，因為第一咧幫助你個背脊痛嘅，能夠relax你啦。第二，如果你有隻枕頭擺咗喺兩個腳之中咧，係能夠幫你係降低你個腳嘅 stress 啦，同埋咧係俾啲安全感俾你嘅。咁呢個咧係你試下呢個係會十分好嘅，因為細路哥好多時都係中攬住個枕頭啦。呢個就比較枕頭喺兩隻腳裏中間。咁其實喺醫院咧，我都擺俾好多病人咧係做呢樣係好好用嘅。So also very important, your pillow has to be also good and also maybe soft enough for you, but not to be over too high pillow. So because you don't want to get a pillow that at the end of the day after sleep I got a stiff neck. And you got a pillow is not too fat, flat. It doesn't support you. Doesn't support your neck naturally. You got to have a very good posture on your bed before you go to sleep. So those pillows can be very important. As you know, a lot of time when you sleep, I want to get my pillow off and you make a pillow. So at the end of the day, you really have to have a good comfortable pillow to give you a good support. So pillow can be something that you really need to consider. Now, a lot of people are different a pillow by, you know, have a neck support and so forth. Consider those pillows. Try it out yourself. It feel good. If it is, try it. And I think that will be important. Help you to make sure your neck don't get pain at the end of the day when you get up. So that is important. 各位朋友，嗱，枕头咧系好重要嘅。如果你枕头系好硬或者好唔舒服， 起起身之後咧個頸又痛，哇！咁你就不如咧就要諗下偉仔係咪可能夠俾你枕頭咧係會更加理想啦。依樣嘢就你要做依樣嘢。咁同埋咧枕頭咧就唔可以太平嘅，唔可以即係話哇好 flat 嘅，亦都好硬嘅。好多時候感覺都 support 嘅，因為枕頭咧要俾一個好 natural 嘅 position 俾你先得嘅。咁依樣嘢你要自己去即係衡量下啦，要去公司得買嘅時候試試。 因為咧瞓覺嘅時候一定要有一個好瞓覺好姿勢，咁你先能夠瞓得舒服嘅。唔好話就咁瞓啦，其實唔係嘅。所以瞓覺你都要好姿勢嘅。Now, a lot of people forgot about the mattress. Okay. Now I'm also a community nurse years ago in Waipahu. I went to North Shore in Hawaii. Man, I found that a lot of people on the metros, you know what they have? They're bucks, okay? And there are lots of bucks. And those bucks actually, without proper seating, is actually come up and start biting the patients. And I said, that's terrible. Wow, look at that. It's all, well, I flipped the blanket. It's all little black little thing running all around. So I said, oh my goodness. And even when I went home, I have to wash my pants, socks, everything, because I was so worried about I took this home. So really, at the end of the day, you have to seal your mattress, box spring, to make sure there's no dust, mites, or other allergies. And that is important, because you have that, you know what? You get sneeze, you got bites, and the allergy will create all kind of itch, allergy for you, and it's going to affect the sleep. And that is no good. And especially the area with moisture area, wow, you got to be very careful, because, you know, I got to share with you a friend of mine who lived in the Peak in Hong Kong, a very rich lady. And unfortunately, the place they have is very moist. And, you know, surprising, you know, you thought that, wow, you know, Hong Kong living in the Peak must be okay. But the bed actually has bugs. And so, you know, really, you know, you got to understand, not necessarily wherever you live, you have to really examine, okay, yourself. So really, at the end of the day, do need to seal properly, mattress, no bugs. So you make sure that it will not create allergy for you, okay? Now, 各位朋友,
好重要的床單,床褥啊,你一定要好照顧它,還有一個好的ceiling,即是封鎖了它啊。因為很多時候,原來床褥裡面有很多叫細的細菌,也都有bugs。那這些生蟲呢,是可能有人咬你又得啦,被allergy你又得啦。哇,其實這個很大問題,因為有時候我是一個叫community nurse,在美國的時候,哇,原來很多人呢,他的床褥裡面呢,有很多是細的 bugs 走出來的。 哇,我的客人都怕,立刻回家都,衣服都全部要洗,如果不然,不知道放在家裡,其實我進去中國的時候,也都看到很多的,我有一次在一間酒店的新酒店的,一看到一塊被子,哇,裡面全部黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑黑
those are a good habit to start. So that way you will always know, 9 o'clock I go to sleep, or 10 o'clock I go to sleep, 11 o'clock I go to sleep. Those are always the time. And I'll always say 6 o'clock. So that will be very, very good. So always set the time when you go to sleep, a certain time is always there. And that will be extremely good for you. Now, 各位同學, 每天呢, 其實呢, 起床睡覺, 你都應該是同樣時間, 就不要說, 啊, 今天是這樣, 明天是第二個時間。 如果最好, 譬如我9點睡覺, 或10點睡覺, 或11點睡覺, 那你就一天都是這個時間。 那你早上起床的時候, 我就always 都是5點半起床, 或6點起床。 如果你做到這個習慣, 哇, 這個是十分好的, 還有5至30分鐘 before 你睡覺之前呢, 就一定要去relax, 不要弄那麼多東西, 又不要開始去做事, 那你呢, 就會變成一個睡覺時間, 又開始習慣, 那你睡眠呢, 就一定會繼續是十分好的。 And you really got to get rid of all the caffeine, okay? Because a lot of people say, wow, you know, I drink some coffee at dinner time. But you know what? When you drink the coffee at dinner time, it affects the sleep 4 hours later. Because usually it takes about 8 hours to get rid of the caffeine. So do not, if you are caffeine sensitive, do not drink coffee or strong tea before sleep. Now, low shu tea is okay because low shu tea has no caffeine. Low shu tea is only have guava leaf and bitter melon that has no caffeine. It doesn't affect the sleep. Matter of fact, it helps you sleep because of the fact that it relaxes you. It's not item to stimulate you. So do avoid caffeine with food or whatever. Like chocolate has also a lot of caffeine in there sometimes. So you eat chocolate at nighttime, like before you go to sleep, it might affect your sleep pattern, okay? Because some sweet to go in there, it will affect the sleep. Plus, it has also caffeine and the chocolate, okay? And on top of that, some of the drug also might affect the sleep. So make sure to check with the doctor, see this drug has no caffeine, okay? So these are things that you have to pay attention. 咖啡因是可能夠 影響瞓覺，尤其是如果你晏夜晚飲咖啡嘅時候咧，咖啡好多時咧有6至8個鐘頭去process呢個咖啡啊。咁呢個咖啡因可能之後咧真係會affect你嘅，所以好多人話：哇，我飲咖啡唔得嘅喎，或者飲茶都唔得嘅喎，啱，真係會影響瞓覺嘅。咁但係去糖茶會影響瞓覺？唔會，因為去糖茶咧係裏邊冇咖啡因嘅，所以其實咧係可以能夠飲咗之後，你都唔會覺得 係搞唔到你瞓覺。咁當然啦，好多食嘅嘢，朱古力啊，係有咖啡因嘅，咁呢個會影響啦。有啲藥物亦都會啦。咁所以如果有藥物咧，就 make sure 你叫醫生轉藥啦。 OK， 嗱，some exercise can be very helpful for your sleep. For example, not aggressive exercise, it's light exercise like Tai Chi. So you do. If you do 3 to 4 hours before you vigor exercise, like lifting weight, you know, before bedtime, that will affect the sleep. The reason is your heart going to start pumping real fast. Your heart rate goes up, your blood pressure goes up because you're vigorous, you know. You lift weight, for example. Those are all not good for you because your butt is just continuing to circulate real big and you are tremendous, ready to fight. And then your heart rate, boom, 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 boom. When you come back, you're not going to slow down or affect the sleep. But on the other hand, if you're a gentle walk, for example, even you do, you know, a 50-minute walk before, after dinner, you know, 1 hour before sleep, those are very good relaxing. And then you can also, if you do Tai Chi, it can be also very good. So just do not do vigorous exercise because that will keep you awake, okay? Now, 各位朋友, 千祈唔好做劇烈運動啊！三個鐘頭裏邊咧，如果你做劇烈運動咧，會令到成身咧都係 ready to fight咧，咁你嘅心咧就 boom 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 boom，咁其實咧會影響佢瞓覺。咁其實咧最好咧就做啲柔軟啲嘅運動啦，或者行啦，行會對你好嘅，係 relax 你啊，咁行就唔係快行啊，慢行喎，講下。咁如果你行咧行1個鐘頭啊，40分鐘咧，係會幫助你瞓覺嘅。或者如果你識太極，可以即係做太極都得啦。就千祈唔好做一啲咧咩啊劇烈運動 lift weight 啊，或者係做一啲
好劇烈嘅運動咧，咁令到心咧係地靈猛咁行咧，咁你就瞓唔到覺噶啦。OK。
Also, do not eat a very heavy meal or late meal. Like a lot of people actually sleep, eat at 11 o'clock at night and try to sleep at 12. Actually, that is really tough for them. You know why? Because your digestive system is have to work on your heavy meal to digest you. So you might affect the sleep. You know, you might feel bloated. You might feel like, you know, somehow I don't know how to, you know, get rid of the food. Stuck, you know, so you do not want to eat heavily, especially 1 hour of your sleep. So it's very bad actually for a lot of people said, I need to have a heavy snack. They really get heavy snack before they go to sleep. So when you do that, actually affect your sleep and it's not going to give you a good digestion also. So you want to have some snack, get light snack, some, for example, fruits, very, very light snack, some nuts, so very light to actually help you to relax and so forth. Now you got very, very, you know, heavy meal. And that is definitely no good, okay?
嗱，各位同學，晚上瞓覺之前咧，千祈唔好食得太多嘢，因為食得太頂住個胃啦，咁你梗係瞓唔到覺啦。同埋咧，個胃咧要學你 process 搶嘢個 process。當你咁多 process 嘅時候咧，你濕，你血壓又會高啦，又會係一係咁喐啦。咁你係瞓唔到覺，依個係唔正正嘅東西，所以千祈唔好再食好多嘢。如果其實瞓覺之前咧，你應該食一個鐘頭前咧就停噶啦，唔可以食太。咁就算如果你要食咧，食啲好 light 嘅食物，譬如 fruit 啊、berries 啊嗰啲就唔好食嗰啲，哇，好 heavy 嘅東西。因為見到好有啲人咧，夜晚瞓覺可能夠未瞓之前咧，真係食碗大嘅雞皮或者鴨腿麵，哇！依、這個就唔正仔啦，因為你會食好多嘢落去嘅時候你要時間 digest 嘅。咁食完之後去瞓覺，係咪瞓得好咧？其實唔係正仔嘅，所以依個咧就唔好食依樣嘢啊。同埋仲有令到血糖高啊。OK， so don't do that.
Another thing too is don't drink alcohol before you sleep. Now, a lot of people say, "Hey, you know, I could able to drink the alcohol, and then I will able to get me sleep better."Well, they found out at 2 o'clock, they start waking up after they drank and they alcohol process. The reason is alcohol actually do affect the sleep. Plus, it take time to metabolize, you know, process your alcohol. It take about few hours to process. And if you a few hours, this process it take you the whole night to kind of wake you up. So you want to do that? No, you don't want to do that. So do not drink alcohol before you sleep.Especially when you do that, a lot of time, you will definitely, during the process, you might definitely wake up. And you wake up, then you can't go back to sleep. A lot of people have that experience after drink alcohol and say, after that, I woke up, and I couldn't go back to sleep. So try not. Well, you know, if you do that, maybe you have a warm cup of milk, low-fat milk. Maybe that's better than alcohol. So try that.And rather than you drink alcohol and try to see whether it makes it doesn't help you out at all.
各位朋友，嗱，唔好飲酒瞓覺，因為飲酒瞓覺咧，其實咧係唔係一個真正好嘅東西嘅。點解咧？因為你飲咗酒之後咧，你係會 take 大概3-4 hours去 process 嗰啲酒啊。咁我嗰陣時咧 process 緊嘅時候咧，就2 hours瞓覺，趌咗起身，趌起身咧瞓唔到覺喎，咁好戇居。咩啊？瞓唔到覺。咁其實最好咧就唔好飲酒啦。咁如果係飲些啲嘅咩，揾啲熱嘅low fat 低脂嘅牛奶啦。咁可能咧依個仲比你飲酒係更加好嘅，幫你瞓覺。
Now, also very important is do not drink fluid 1 hour before sleep. Now, as you know, when you drink fluid, regular fluid.When you drink, right, go to sleep, 1 hour. Why is that? Now, for example, our instruction to drink Lu Shu tea 1 hour before. There is a reason because when you drink 1 hour before Lu Shu tea, one hour before sleep, you drink Lu Shu tea, your body very quickly will actually process the Lu Shu tea and you will able to go urinate within 30 or 40 minutes. So you will.Urinate before you go to sleep, so it won't affect you actually go to sleep.
But if you drink a lot of fluid and then sometimes fluid, not like lo shu tea, might not necessarily 1 hour you will go to shishi, it will take you maybe 2-3 hours later. Then maybe at that time you'll get up, your bathroom, and maybe go several times to do that, to go to bathroom. So that way you end up to really go to a lot of bathroom, so you're not able to sleep well. And on top of that, a lot of time when you go to a bathroom, make sure your bathroom light is actually low or doesn't turn on the light bright. You know, sometimes people just sleep and with the bathroom door open, that's also no good to you. So make sure when you go to sleep 1 hour before, you can drink fluid, not just before go sleep, drink some fluid. That's why we have lo shu tea advise you folks 1 hour before sleep, you drink lo shu tea, and most likely within that 1 hour, you void, you go shishi, and on top of that, you will actually lower your blood sugar, and that's why that will be extremely good for you. 各位同學,千萬不要去一個小時前,不是,一個短一個小時,剛剛睡覺裡面是立刻喝東西,喝了水之後,你晚上就是小便,就睡不到覺了,所以喝去糖茶,我叫一個小時 before 睡覺之前去喝去糖茶,有解的,因為喝去糖茶,你30至40分鐘你就會去小便了,那你變了未睡覺之前就去小便了。 因為它是steam來的,它是小便,因為它是屙了糖,屙了cholesterol,屙了鹽出來嘛,那它一定steam來這件事的,但是水就未必是,所以如果你喝水呢,半夜兩點鐘,三點起床,或者四點又再起床,那你就睡不到覺。還有呢,如果你進了洗手間,忘記關燈,還有燈照著你,那make sure不要做這件事。When we sleep, make sure we have all the light turned off. Because when you're light, a lot of times that the brain will tell, hey, it's about time to go to work, it's daytime. So you really might not really get you to go to sleep. So turning off the light actually is important. Simple things like that. So turn off the light before you go to sleep, okay? 各位同學,記住,睡覺的時候一定要熄燈,因為你不熄燈睡覺的時候,腦子以為,啊,是喔, 我要上班了,其實不是的,這個一定要關燈的,因為很多時候,當你不關燈的時候,你是真的以為自己要準備上班,這個是有一個問題,是令到你睡不著覺的。And on top of that, you got to have all the noises, keep it loud, keep it low, and especially if dogs or whatever, which make sure that, you know, all those noise can keep it low. And make sure that if a lot of people say, hey, I really am very sensitive, well, get earplugs. And you get the earplugs, then maybe with that, you can eliminate all the noise and will give you a better sleep. So keeping the noise low is very important. And it is good. It gives you a very quiet environment. You can able to sleep. 各位朋友,因為睡覺的時候,真的要將聲音全部降低,還有make sure 水喉不會滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴滴 So even if that, if you have dogs that will sleep with you, and I know a lot of dogs actually sleep with you, many of us who have dogs, that the dogs love to come under the bed. So make sure the dog don't just move around, because when they move around, they wake you up. So hopefully they're also able to sleep on your bed, not on your bed, but on the bottom of your bed, so it doesn't bother you. And on top of that, you know, animal has fleas, so also create allergies. So you got to make sure that they don't have fleas. So very important, more important, make sure that they sleep on the bottom of the bed, not to get on you, and then you move, and they will affect the sleep. 各位朋友，如果你有狗咧，狗啊好中意同你瞓覺嘅，咁但係或者如果佢成日喐嚟喐去咧，咁你瞓唔到覺啦，咁希望只狗啊翻喺你床頭啦，唔係放喺你個床嗰度。如果唔係咧，即係會係end up瞓唔到覺。咁其實咧，仲有咧，狗同貓啊都一樣嘅，佢有虱啦，咁亦都跳跳拱啦，或者會虱啦，係令到你咧咬你啦，咁你有allergy啊，瞓唔到覺啦。 And before you go to sleep, you gotta have also some relaxing exercise, especially 2 to 3 hours before sleep. You gotta get your brain, get rid of the business, turn it off. A lot of time you might listen some very nice and soft music, and maybe or even taking a warm bath to relax you. All these things can help you to really get better health to sleep. So relax yourself when you go to sleep. 各位朋友一定要放鬆，瞓到覺。如果唔係咧，你瞓太過即係 stress 啦，就瞓唔到覺。咁好重要咧，就兩個至三個鐘頭裏邊咧，before 瞓覺之前咧，最好就唔好諗生意啊，諗嘢樣啦，或者聽下靜啲音樂啊，同埋一啲可能有啲人中意睇書啊，或者可以沖下涼啊、熱水涼啊都得嘅。所以呢啲咧，全部都係一啲好嘅東西，令到你 relax 個 objective 係 relax。 So a lot of people thought that, well, I can't sleep. Maybe I should use some sleeping pill. Is that a good idea? No. You don't want to depend sleeping pill to get a habit to get you to sleep. Because with that, you have a psychological dependence. Matter of fact, a lot of doctors will not recommend to a long-term use of sleeping pill. You should only for short-term solution, one or two pills, stop. Because you have continued using sleeping pill, actually you will get very, very dependent, and it's not going to help you on sleep down the road, because you're psychologically, even you can sleep, you are so dependent. I haven't taken my pill, I can't sleep. Don't do that, because that is not good for you. 各位同學，記住咧，就唔好避免食安眠藥嘅 dependence， 即係我要有瞓覺一定食安眠藥，咁就唔正仔嘅。Okay? So you gotta actually basically not to depend on your sleeping pill. You should only take as a short-term solution, like 1 or 2 days, and then get rid of it, and that's it. 唔好話即係做呢個安眠藥嘅習慣咗，呢個係唔正嘅。所有醫生都唔會想咁做嘅，記住。 And on top of that, you might want to talk to your doctor. Why you know you cannot sleep? If you have 1 month, you cannot sleep whole day. I mean, one whole month, I couldn't sleep. So you might need to talk to the doctor, give you a little more solutions, okay? And maybe a lot of time you have some actual issue, physical issue, like acid influx. You know, like for example, your esophagus continue to put out, you know, acid coming out. So you have a hot burn feeling here, and your neck here is also burned. It could be you have asthma, you can't breathe. Could be arthritis, which is getting pain, okay? All that might need solution, not by just what we just talked about. So you need a doctor help to help you to create some drugs to help you, or exercise to help you, or whatever. Worse that a lot of people don't realize is depression, because a lot of people don't think about depression. Because psychological thing is embarrassing. I'm depressed. Are you kidding me? I cannot be depressed. So a lot of people don't want to talk about it. But as today's, especially COVID-19, all these things come along, chances of depression is high. So you really need to talk to your doctor, see whether you need to help on depression. So these are things that you want to think about. not necessarily you have to do it, but you do think about it to help you to, you know, to be sensitive to it and ask for doctor help. 各位朋友，如果一个月后以后咧，你瞓唔到觉咧，咁其实要睇医生啦，因为可能咧系其他嘅问题啦。For example 啦，我有哮喘啦，或者有依个胃酸倒流啦，咁令到你呢度咧就好唔舒服啦，有 heartburn 啦，同埋拉住喉咙啦，咁同埋咧就可能有依个不同嘅风湿痛啦。咁呢啲嘢全部咧系要揾医生帮手俾药你食嘅。咁仲有一个好重要咧，其实好多人都唔了解，亦都唔防御咧，就系、是、可能忧郁症。因为好多时咧，忧郁症系一个症咧，系一个好 embarrassing 嘅啊。唔系咁，我哋有冇搞错啊？咁唔系咁讲，其实要系正视嘅。咁如果真系可能有忧郁，而家好多人有忧郁，有即系 COVID-19 啊，定点算啊？苏联打仗啊，点算啊？好多令到好多忧郁嘅，咁你系要真系要可能要睇下医生呢样嘢，去俾医生研究下。So it's important you have to actually talk to doctors to help yourself and see whether that is something that they can help you. So these are the suggestions I have. So in conclusion, it is so important for diabetic, pre-diabetic to really get plenty high quality sleep. And if you don'tActually, your body will, blood sugar goes up, your immunity go down, you might not necessarily get you good health, okay? So good sleep is so important. And really, at the end of the day, 20 ways to do that is very simple. One, you have to shut off your phone, all the blue light cannot come out, and then you might be able to take some 20-minute nap during the afternoon, early in the afternoon, not late afternoon, or take a walk, or drink some cold water, take away from the environment, relax a little bit in the middle of the day. And you have to cover your alarm clock. Don't let the blue light alarm clock to bother you, or especially the alarm clock that tick, 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 also can bother you. Maybe also sleep with a pillow in between the two legs to decrease the leg, hip pressure and back pressure, and also give you some comfort.The pillow has to pay attention, must be soft. Make sure it don't get you to be, hard to, your neck can be an issue. And also a mattress has to be sealed, make sure that it doesn't have bugs. And also you should, before you go to sleep, you gotta be very relaxed. You should also take a habit of sleep at the same time, wake up at the same time.And make sure you not take caffeine when you, before you go to sleep. Caffeine will affect you as sometimes 6 to 8 hour processes caffeine. You also need to do some very light exercise, not vigorous exercise, because it will get your heart to pumped up, then it's not going to help you. And then you also don't eat heavy meal, because when you eat heavy meal, it's going to take time to process your body. Don't drink alcohol before sleep, because alcohol will take time to process. And when you've processed,And it will probably wake you up in the middle of the night. And then you are drink fluid, you drink 1 hour before you sleep. Now, low shu tea is good to drink out before you sleep because you're 30, 40 minutes, you'll go void already. You go shishi. And when you urinate, you get rid of all the sugar and salt and cholesterol out. So you will sleep good. Your light has to turn off. Don't turn on your light when you sleep. And I'll make sure you have no noise.Or very limited noise that don't bother you. If it bothers you, put the earplugs on it to help you eliminate noise. Do not smoke, because when you smoke, it's just like caffeine. Tobacco is like caffeine that stimulates you and continue to stimulate you. It's not going to make you sleep. So if you have dogs in the bed or so, you make sure the dog doesn't walk around you all the time. They should sleep in the middle bottom of your bed rather than sleep with you. That will...We'll walk around, wake you up. So that is going to be, you got to watch that. You have to also relax all the time before you sleep. Usually takes 1 to 2 hours to relax you. Do some music, do some reading and so forth to help you out. And really, I'm highly suggest not to do sleeping pills because your sleeping pill only a short-term solution, not a long-term solution. If you're sleeping pill dependent, it's going to be really screw up your whole body.And try not to do that. If 30 days you couldn't sleep, you talk to the doctor, identify other problems. Maybe your arthritis problem, your depression problem,
So those are things you need to pay attention. 嗱，各位朋友，啊，就算你係前期患者，或者我係你係依個啊糖尿患病者，一定要話好 quality、好質量嘅食物睡眠，因為如果唔係咧，你瞓唔到覺嘅時候咧，你有一個好大嘅問題出現，就係你嘅血糖上升。咁如果你瞓得好嘅話咧，你身體一定好嘅，咁你免疫力都好嘅，咁你一定會健康嘅，咁 is very good for you。咁其實最重要咧就係你首先要 turn off 曬啲手提電話、電視啊，因為藍燈會影響瞓覺嘅。第二樣嘢，如果你係日頭去瞓啊，晏晝係十分好噶。如果你瞓咗二十分鐘喺晏食晏晝後咧去瞓覺，啊 so good for you， 令到你咧能夠會一個成身都改變咗你身心。如果你唔瞓咧，你出去行下十分至二十分鐘都 good 嘅，或者飲啲去糖茶熱嘅凍都可以 relax 啊，轉換下環境。咁其實咧，重要咧，好重要咧，就將你個alarm clock turn off， 唔好話喺度著燈，或者同埋滴滴滴滴滴啊去，咁啊做咧因為個滴滴滴咧就令到瞓覺瞓唔到嘅。咁其實咧，你仲有可以幫你係令到瞓覺好咧，係將個枕頭俾兩個腳之間咧，係令到你能夠更加令到你背脊唔會痛啦，令到亦都覺得啊好似好舒服咁啦，依個好重要嘅。咁同埋咧，你個枕頭咧係咪係一個好舒服嘅枕頭，令到頸唔會痛咧？依個亦都係嘅。咁同埋咧，牀個褥裏邊咧 ，make sure 咧唔會有好多微生物啊、細嘅 bugs 啊，咁令到你一出嚟咬你啊，整 allergy 啊，咁你周身痕啊，亦都係一個好大問題。咁同埋咧，仲有咧係隻牀咧係俾你能夠去 relax 嘅。咁你咧全 make sure 唔喺度做嘢啦，同埋咧你仲有咧每日咧係習慣一個睡眠咧係同樣嘅時間，係譬如話晏晝啊，唔係 sorry， 我係每晚咧九點鐘瞓覺就九點鐘瞓覺，十點十點鐘瞓覺，朝頭早。五點起身或者六點咧，我日日都係咁咧，咁就 very good 嘅。OK，make sure 係瞓七個鐘頭。OK， 咁仲有咧係唔好飲啲咖啡因。OK， 因為咖啡因咧要六至八個鐘頭去 process 嘅。咁你飲咗之後咧，你就瞓唔到覺噶啦。咁同埋咧，一定係做啲細容易嘅運動，細小運動或柔軟運動行啦。就唔好做啲劇烈運動，因為劇烈運動咧令到心臟咧會嘣嘣嘣嘣嘣，你瞓唔到覺啊！咁唔好食得太嘅 heavy 啦，食 heavy 亦都要成個腸要 process 食物咧，亦都令到瞓唔到覺啦。咁仲有咧就唔好飲酒啦，飲酒亦都令到你一半盞起身，因為你酒 process 嘅半鐘起身。咁同埋咧係一個鐘頭前咧就唔好飲嘢啦。咁如果飲去糖茶，點解一個鐘頭咧？就因為去糖茶飲一個鐘頭咧。即係瞓覺之前一個鐘頭飲香兩茶，你大約三十至四十分鐘你就會小便嘅。咁小便咧就將你糖啊、鹽啊同埋你 cholesterol 就掉咗出嚟，咁就十分好嘅。咁同埋咧，仲有一樣咧，將所有燈熄咗佢，同埋唔好有聲音，因為聲音令到你瞓覺係唔舒服啦。咁千祈唔好食煙啦，食會 steam 嚟你唔瞓唔到覺啦。如果有狗咧，就 make sure 啲狗咧瞓喺呢個牀尾裏邊啦，就唔係放喺同一齊瞓啦。咁 before 一個鐘頭至兩個鐘頭表瞓緊之前 relax 曬，聽下音樂啊，睇下書啊，咁同埋咧就唔好食安眠藥啦。安眠藥係唔可以永遠係同你一齊去影響瞓覺，係一個 short term 短暫嘅兩三日就 OK 嘅啫。如果一個月後你瞓唔到覺，咁你真係揾醫生傾下偈啦。OK。So today is my lecture. I hope that you enjoy it. If you have any question.You can write to me. I'm very happy to answer you. And this is my connecting information. Right here, this is my email, andy@wafong.com. You can do that. Or you can WhatsApp me also at 852-6792-8891 or 852-3001-5644 or call us. Okay, if you want to do that.But nevertheless, write to us. This is our email address. So I will be open for any question you might have. And so, I have a nice question. One question is from Eugene. Eugene always have a good question. Okay, so it said afternoon nap. Minimum is 20 minutes. And what is the maximum? Actually, maximum is no more than 1 hour. You don't want to sleep too long. The minimum 20 minutes is good because you want that 20 minute cat nap to able to wake you up, sleep and regenerate your refreshness. So 20 to 30 minutes is a very good one. If you need to sleep longer, no more than 1 hour. So the maximum, no more than 1 hour. Eugene always 问一个好好嘅问题咧。如果你瞓晏觉系20分钟就 OK at minimum 啊。咁如果最长瞓咗几多啊？就千祈唔好瞓多过一钟头。其实最好咧就20至30分钟系一个好东西嘅。你瞓完觉之后咧，你会觉得成个人精神晒、爽晒，成个晏昼都做嘢十倍好嘅。OK， 所以你系会系make sure 你瞓觉咧。唔瞓多過一個鐘頭，最好就係20至30分鐘。OK， so the nap, cat nap is only 20 to 30 minutes the best. If you need to sleep longer, no more than 1 hour. OK, so another question is, if I exercise, how much time before sleep for light exercise? Now, light exercise should be like walking. So usually you took 20, I mean, sorry, you no more than 40 minutes walk will be good.Because you don't want to be overexert yourself. So you can do a 40-minute walk will be good. Some people take half an hour. That would be also good. But the key is don't overstress yourself. It's mainly light exercise. It's not like, wow, 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 you know, to do vigor exercise. I found that if I walk half an hour to 20 minutes, man, that night I slept real good. And the reason is because it relaxes you.And you walk around, and usually what I do is I either walk shopping mall or walk with my dogs, and that will be also helpful. And so really good to do that to help you to end up not to overstress yourself. So 如果夜晚做 exercise 呢，咁你就应该呢，最好呢，就做呢个睡觉呢，是睡在做 exercise 未瞓觉之前咧，最好就30至40分钟行啦，咁就好嘅。如果你行半个钟头40分钟咧，你会好舒服嘅人，系行喎，唔系走喎，亦都唔系快行喎，系慢慢行。OK， 咁令到瞓觉好舒服嘅。So another question is low fat milk. It should be cold low fat milk. Also okay to warm. Actually, warm is actually better for low fat milk because.When you when you have warm milk actually relax you. Warm milk is better relaxation than cold. Okay, so always drink some small amount of warm low fat milk is better. Okay, so to relax you, should use warm low fat milk. Okay.嗱，飲牛奶係應該飲暖嘅牛奶最好 ，cold 就得嘅，但係暖係更加好嘅。所以有啲人咧中意唔中意飲熱嘅，咁 OK 啦。如果有 warm milk 咧，係能夠令到個腸胃啊更加係 relax 係舒服啲嘅。OK， how about melatonin as a medication? Now you cannot depend on that for a long time. It's only short.Like couple night, three night, it's okay, but not for long. Okay, 所有藥物咧就千祈唔好食 too long， 因為食 too long 食 too 即係 dependent 咧係唔正仔噶，記住啊。So when you sleep on your back, how do you know your body align? Okay, another question from Gordon is very good. When you align well, your back will be basically.To make sure you align is you felt that you are sleep in a position that you're comfortable. Because it's very difficult to say you are aligned correctly or not. The most important when you lie down, especially you lie down on your back, you make sure you felt that your body it feel totally comfortable, not in the sense that I feel pain here and there or something stuck in here and there. So to align better is make sure that you sleep.A very comfortable supine position. And also when you tilt, make sure that you tilt in such a way that you also feel very comfortable. If you are very comfortable, most likely your body aligned. Okay? So I hope I answered your question. 睡覺呢，如果你就平睡呢，怎能夠令到你呢，是覺得是真的很舒服啊，是不是啱不啱啊，個 body 啱啊。其實最重要的睡覺的時候，你個 body 呢，
就應該係要喺瞓咗落去嘅時候咧，全身係好舒服嘅，係唔係應該係瞓到出嚟咧？我依度好硬啊，個依度唔係好舒服啊，嗰度唔得，即係唔係 align 啦。咁你瞓咗落去咧，係要好，因為你自己要感覺到嘅呢樣嘢。咁如果你 turn left or turn right 咧？都是要感觉到呢是很舒服的，所以这个呢 align 是要自己去觉得舒服就应该 align 的。I have a question from Pat. Thank you, Pat. You are very good to ask a question. If you put a pillow in between your where do you put this pillow? Your pillow should be on your thigh area to all the way to on the knee. Where do you put it? 個問題咧，阿 Pat 個問題咧問得好嘅。佢係個枕頭放喺邊度啊？其實就放喺呢個大髀同埋你個膝頭哥同埋小腿嗰度嘅兩個嚇，咁啊接住。咁嗰度咧係夾住咧，咁啊大髀啊大髀依度啦，膝頭哥依度啦，同埋小腿依度啦。咁你夾住佢咧嘅時候咧，其實咧你係能夠令到你咧，你可能打側少瞓咧，你係覺得你個背脊係十分舒服嘅，同埋仲有一樣嘢咧，係令到你有一個好安全感啊！我唔知道你記唔記得你細佬哥嘅時候咧，你瞓覺好咧時候攬住個身嚟瞓覺，亦都有試過咧係擺喺個枕頭，咁令到這個呢個咧係令到你擺個大髀。同埋膝頭哥同埋小腿嗰度咧，你令到你係好舒服咧，令到減低你個背脊個痛楚咧係好好嘅。Okay, so do that and try yourself and see how comfortable that is. It'll give you a lot of comfort and give you a lot of decrease your pain. So keep that in mind when you do this. Make sure you put a pillow on your thigh and the knee and the lower leg.You will feel very, very comfortable, and you will feel also a comfort, decrease the stress on your back, and especially you turn left and turn right. We do a lot of that for our actually long-term patient in bed. We do that. So make sure you put that pillow on the thigh, knee, and the lower extremity. You put it in between that, then you will be so good for you.And that will try that. You will feel very, very comfortable. Feel like you get some more comfort and also decrease the stress on your back. Okay. So, 放个枕头喺个大髀、膝头哥同埋个小腿嗰度，嗰两个夹住佢咧，你会令到你咧个成身咧都舒服晒嘅。So good. I'm so glad everybody asked some questions. I thank you for Pat asked me question. 多谢阿 Pat 啊，问啲问题啦 ，Pat 好好啊。咁亦都I thanks Eugene, Gordon asked so many good questions, and I hopefully that we'll continue to see you. I hope that this will help you to get you sleep better every night. And this is so important for you because you sleep well, even though you're not diabetic, you get better health, and you will get better rest. And next morning, you'll do a lot more things that are much better. Thank you again.I appreciate all your question and answer. I'll see you next week. Thank you. Bye-bye.